Hello, my name is Mike, and I'm going to teach you how to update your form's confirmation actions in WordPress. A few months ago, we created the first three videos in this series on how to build an instant estimate power washing form in WordPress. By using Formidable, we were able to use no code to do so. But we got dangerously close to doing so when it came to the final step, the form outcomes or confirmation action. We had to program quite a bit of conditional logic using shortcodes to make it work. But now that we've released 6.0 with its updated confirmation actions, we can make it a lot easier. Let's get started. First, let's get our instant estimate form. We actually turned the form we made in the previous three parts of this series into a template so you don't need to make it from scratch. Still worth watching the videos to see how it works though. Here's the form. Let's go into the settings. You'll see the alert bar to let you know we've moved our onSubmit confirmation actions to join the rest of the form actions in this tab. And if we go there, we'll see one confirmation action with the message type and a whole lot of text. This is fine and still works. If you had forms made before the update, we obviously didn't want to break them. But it is more complicated than it needs to be with this new tool, so let's update it. We can see that we use conditional logic to find out which of the four tiers of service they need. And it does it by checking if that tier is not equal to zero. And then it displays a message about the total price as well as a link to where they can schedule their appointment, regardless of tier. Okay, let's duplicate this confirmation action just so we can refer to it and edit this new one. Let's call it basic after the first tier. We'll delete the logic around basic as well as every other tier. We'll leave the total and link. And now let's set the conditional logic for the basic tier. If pwconvertBasic does not equal zero, then we want this to display. Great. Let's update to save this. That way when we hit duplicate, it will also duplicate the conditional logic. We'll duplicate this basic confirmation action three times for the other tiers. I'll rename them after their tiers, standard, advanced, and total, and update the conditional logic with the right field. But obviously, the does not equal and zero stay the same. Then, from our original confirmation action, I'll copy the text for each of those tiers and paste them in their respective confirmation actions. Finally, let's turn off the original confirmation action that we don't need anymore. You can delete it if you want, but I'm just going to turn it off in case I made a mistake somewhere and I need to reference it. Great, let's update to save again and then test it out. I'll just randomly fill out this form so we can make sure that the logic still works. There we go, it works. And that's how to update your confirmation actions with conditional logic using Formidable Forms. Subscribe for more form building and Formidable Forms tips, and I'll see you next time.